What is up, everybody? Welcome to episode 83 of the Geekcast. I am Bobby, the Nintendo guru, joined by my lovely wife, Toni.
Hello, everybody.
So everybody understands. I work for a company that sells flowers. I'm in the shipping department for them. And obviously with Valentine's next week or the week after, whatever. My schedule's a little messed up and I had to work today. So Toby, because he's 5 hours ahead of me, definitely was not going to come on at midnight to record an episode. So in order to salvage this, Toni jumped in.
I'm the last resort.
Not really. I could have asked other people, but I was like, all right, I'll ask my wife. But it's been like almost a year, I think, maybe a little more, since you've been here. You were actually on an episode with Karina.
I was.
I don't know the number, but in our first year that Toby and I were doing the podcast, you were on. So let's kick this episode off like we do each and every episode with our geek outs. Toni, what are you geeking out about?
You know, Netflix.
Why Netflix?
Because they have such good stuff on right now, like very nostalgic old TV shows, like the Gilmore Girls and things like that. And it's just, I don't know, I'm liking it. And Fuller House.
Whatever.
Gotta love Fuller House. You know you watch it.
I haven't watched Fuller House in season one.
You didn't watch the second
season. I didn't watch the second season.
The second season was better.
I mean, I probably will eventually. I just haven't had the urge.
You don't like all that nostalgic stuff. Like, you don't like all that.
I'm not stuck in a time warp, is what you're saying.
I'm not stuck in a time warp.
Yeah, you are. Yeah.
No. You have to watch it.
Whatever. Myself, I am geeking out because we are less than 30 days from the Switch hitting my hands, and I cannot wait to get my hands on this thing. Like, I am amped up. I am really excited for this thing, and I cannot wait because it's going to be just... I'm looking forward to it. I just think it's going to be pretty awesome. So, let's jump into what we're playing. Toni, what have you been playing?
I've been playing Fallout 4.
I'm sure Chelsea Capri is listening right now. I'm very happy.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts?
You know, I'm like so into this game now. When I get into a game, I'm like into it too. I've been every night in bed on my iPad reading about like how to do things. I've learned so much stuff reading online that there's just so much to the game. I mean, like more than you would think.
Yeah.
And I feel like you have to read like some kind of guide or, you know, just the internet to learn things. Like I didn't even know you could scrap the houses.
Like tear them down.
Yeah, and like use that for materials and things. Yeah. I would have never have known that. I'm thinking here, like, how am I going to get steel and cloth and all this stuff? Now I know.
Yeah. What, whereabouts are you? Like, what's your...
Well, if I was following the storyline, I'm supposed to be helping out, you know, trying to find more Minutemen.
Mm-hmm.
I have the settlers and one of the Minutemen in the sanctuary town now. And I'm building stuff for them. I have a couple of side things that I can do also.
Side quests, yes.
Yeah, the side quests. Or I could just do whatever. I was starting on one side quest. I was at the satellite station Olivia, I think it's called. And I'm not doing too good there right now. Because they have better weapons than I do right now. So I just thought that I would do that just to check it out. But I think I'm going to go back to my sanctuary town and just start kind of building that up first.
You're a lot further than I am, or I was, and I quit pretty quick. But whatever.
It's crazy though, because that's not really a game that I'm into.
Yeah,
like,
that's
usually.
That's strange. That's because when you told me you wanted that, I was like, wow, that's a bit of a stretch. What made you want to play it anyway? Where did that come from?
Honestly, the retro stuff in it. See, there I go with my retro.
Yeah, but no. But I'm saying, like, I get that, but where did it come from? Because it's been out a while ago, and I haven't played it in forever.
I don't know why. Just, you know, honestly, from Christmas shopping for you, I saw a lot of stuff about Fallout.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, wow, you know, I really need to check this game out, because just the old style stuff kind of appealed to me, and then I started really like reading about the actual game, and then I just said, well, that kind of sounds like something I would be into. Kind of reminds me, like the building part reminds me almost of a Minecraft kind of, because you got to go around getting stuff to build, and you know, I like stuff like that.
It's a lot of ultimate stuff. So I haven't had a lot of time to play, but so I Yoshi's Woolly World came out for the 3DS yesterday, and I wasn't gonna get it. I was like, I got it on the Wii U. I'm not gonna get it. This is pointless. This is stupid. Why do I need it again? And I beat it on the Wii U, so I was like, there's really no need to go back and get it again and all that stuff. But what happened was, I played a demo on the 3DS, and I was like, oh my God, this thing is so good. I gotta get it again. And what I did was, because last week, David Moore from Shelved and Forgotten podcast and a bunch of other podcasts that he does, he was telling me, like, he deleted his pre-order for the game and the Poochie amiibo, and he told me go to GameStop. And last week I sent you into GameStop, and I was like, just see if you could pre-order the Poochie, and you did. I haven't picked it up yet. I gotta go, man. I gotta go.
Is it out now? I didn't
It's
even know
out.
if
It
it was
came out
out.
yesterday. I gotta go get it. So I was like, all right, I don't need the game. I'm good. I'm good to go. And then I had $50 gift card to Nintendo eShop from Christmas that you gave me, and I was like, let me just. The demo, I'll just try it. I want to see what it, and I fell in love again. And I was like, all right. So I downloaded a demo this morning before work, and I was playing a little bit just a second ago, and I love the game. The game is so good, man. It looks gorgeous. It does. They did a really good job with it on the 3DS, which shocks me because it went from the Wii U to the 3DS, and that's not normal. Normally, it would go from the 3DS to the Wii U, and they did a good job with it, so.
Here's something shocking. I haven't played with my 3DS in a long time. This morning I actually plugged it in because I want to download Yoshi.
Woolly World?
Yeah, I
Really?
really want to play it.
It's a good game, man. It really is a
It's
good
just
game.
it's so amazing how it
Yeah, it looks
looks. I
gorgeous.
mean, and
Looks
plus I
amazing.
like Yoshi. I'm
Yeah.
like I he's my favorite. So
So, I got a couple topics, and we'll see how much we actually get knocked through here and go. But I kind of, Brendan Myers, he's a friend of the show, and he follows me on Twitter. And he's always constantly like messaging Sean and I and emailing us, and he's good, really good supporter of everything that we do. And he sent me a tw well, I sent a tweet out this morning telling people you were going to be on, and was like, hey, if you guys got any questions, shoot them along. But he asked, what game gets you really competitive? So I wanted to do that before we kind of jumped into the show and do all that. So what game do you feel get you really competitive when it comes to video games?
Mario Kart. I'm so bad. So bad. I'm screaming at the TV, cussing things out. And especially playing against Bobby. It's because he's competitive too. And he like kind of tries, he likes to rub in that he's, you know, beating you all the time. So then that gives me even more amped up. But that game's, oh, I can't.
That's why it's good there's no voice chat, because probably Sean would hate me because I constantly like talk trash the whole time.
You guys
But
are so lucky you don't have to hear that, because
I do. I'm pretty
she's
bad.
so bad.
But we can't even play games together, like, because
Yeah.
I'm yelling at her the whole time. Like,
Oh, yeah.
I think the one time we played Mario and I was yelling at you the whole time, and you were getting mad at me because I was just like,
There's the one where I could play Luigi with you, right? I don't
yeah,
know.
and I was like, come on, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, and but
Because he
whatever.
can fly through games, like, no problem, because he's the guru, you
Oh,
know? So.
please. Yeah, right.
I'm like a little bit more slower, so, but that playing Mario Kart just, yeah, I'm bad.
For me, Splatoon really gets me fired up. Like, I love Mario Kart, and I'm not taking anything from Mario Kart. But for me, Splatoon, like, really gets me ramped up when I'm playing.
Another.
Because I feel like, I really do. I feel like I'm one of the best people in all of my friends that can play Splatoon. Like,
Really?
whenever I play online, like, I can really rack up points and I can really do damage. And I'm really excited for Splatoon 2. I cannot wait for that game. But I just feel like that game, when I get in, and especially if I'm playing against people that are really good, I get fired up where I just want to like figure out a way to take them out and be. And then when I do, when I reverse the roles and I'm now not getting attacked every 5 seconds, it just fires me up. I love
that
it.
That drives me crazy too. I want to kind of, that makes me competitive too. When somebody like the snipers or whatever are just killing you over and over again, then I just want to be like, oh, I'm going to come after you now.
Yeah. So the first topic that I kind of came together with and I thought of was childhood memories in video games. What's one of your, I guess, fondest memories of video games as a kid growing up?
Ooh, I have a lot of them actually. I started off with the Atari, the 2600, mm-hmm. and that's the first thing I remember playing. And I mean, I used to play a game called Mega Mania, and that I played that constantly. I probably was not good at it because, I mean, I'm like 4 or 5 years old playing this game. It's basically, I don't know if you ever played it,
no,
but it's, I guess it would sort of be like you're shooting upwards, kind of like a Space Invaders, and mm-hmm. you have like all these different things that you have to kill. Like there's little spaceships and there's rocks falling down and, mm-hmm. you know, so you're basically shooting. It's very similar to Space Invaders.
Yeah.
That and Frogger and Pitfall all the time I played.
I mean, we had the Atari and I was always constantly playing like River Raid and Pitfall and all that stuff. Like there was a lot of decent games on the Atari. Probably, I don't know if I would say fondest memories, and that's not really what I'm looking for, but one of my memories as a childhood was my brother and my cousin. They're such assholes. And they would always do this thing where we get together, our parents would go, we got to the point where like when the original Nintendo came out, I was 15 and so Toni and Jamie were 13, and our parents would go out all the time and they would let us stay home alone. And so my dad or my mom would like order pizzas and then leave money, and then they would go out to dinner with my uncle and my aunt, and the three of us would hang out and play Nintendo and eat pizza. And one of the things that we would do is we would make a rule where the one game that we were them two wanted to play Mario all the time, and I wanted to play Mike Tyson's Punch-Out all the time. So what they would do is they would say, like, we're going to play until we die. When you die, the game's over, you pass the controller. Well, I, like a dummy, I would want to fight Mike Tyson all the time, and he'd knock me out in like 20 seconds. They'd get on Mario Brothers, and they would just play forever and ever. And I was like, so finally they would die, and I'd get my shot, and I'd go in, and I'd be done in 20, 30 seconds. They're like, okay, our turn. And I was like,
that's funny.
Oh, they used to do that stuff to me all the time. It used to drive me up the wall. Them two would get together and just always plot against me and do stuff. Because they're like only like 2 weeks apart from each other, age-wise. Mm-hmm. Like, so Jamie's older by 2 weeks than my brother. And I'm 2 years older than them two. And they just constantly would do stuff like that. Like, all the time. Just constantly do stuff like that. And then,
well, if you're, like, playing video, like, I never really played video games with friends or anything like that. Mm-hmm. And I was younger. I was a lot younger than you when the original Nintendo came out. Yeah. I was, like, 8, I guess.
Yeah.
7 or 8. And so I would play Bubble Bobble all the time with my mom. And we mm-hmm. actually finished that game yeah. together. Or just, like, listening to my mom playing Zelda, the original Zelda. She was so into that. Yeah. And I will always remember that. Every time I hear the song for Zelda, it just reminds me of my mom.
I was telling Sean this one time, and you know, I mean, you know, obviously, you know, David Weber, my cousin, and David, what I would do is I would call David up and I'd be like, what are you doing? He'd be like, oh, I'm playing Kung Fu or something. And I would tell him, like, put the phone next to the TV so I can listen to you play. And like an idiot, I'm just sitting there listening to him play the game, and I'm imagining the levels in my head as he's playing, and I'm like, so stupid. And Sean was like, that was the original Let's Play. And I'm like, yeah, pretty much. Like, that's what I would do. Dave Maxwell, too, was another one where Dave would come over. We would go to the corner. We would walk down to the corner store. He Cumberland always,
Farms.
He, Cumberland Farms. He would always say this to me. He would always, because he'll bring it up occasionally now. He'll be like, Cumberland Farms, we go down, we buy like a pack of Susie Q's and then a 1 liter soda, like of like grape soda or orange soda or something that was like, it was a Cumberland Farms brand soda. So it was just like a no frills like soda.
Real cheap.
Yeah, you wouldn't buy the cola because the cola was nasty. So yeah, we'd buy like, I don't know, typically we'd buy grape or orange. Get a 1 liter of soda, a pack of Susie Q's. Sometimes we buy the mini cheeseburgers that they used to have. You put them in the microwave, and then we would walk back to my house, and we would play baseball games on the NES all the time. And when we were kids, what me and Dave used to do was we would always, like, we had a notebook, so we would play, and they never collected stats. So what we would do is we would make our own stats, and we would track our own stats. And, like, so I'd be up, and I'd get a hit, and then we'd have to stop, and I'd have to write down base hit. And then we'd like fill out the lineup card, like all of our players, and then like I'd get an out and I'd write down I got an out. But then eventually Baseball Stars came out, and that was, to this day, when you talk to Dave or I, that's our favorite baseball game of all time. Like, it was just way ahead of its time. It tracked stats. You could sell players, you could trade players, you could fire players, hire players, like all this crazy stuff. And you could, like, it was the first baseball game you could actually climb the wall to steal home runs and, like, all this crazy stuff he used to do. And we played that game forever, like, all the time, every day. And it also tracked stats. So it was way ahead of its time when it came to stuff like that. So him and
Did
I
that
loved,
come out after Bases Loaded?
I think it
came
that out,
one
like,
was cheesy.
I think it came out, like, right around the same time, if I'm not mistaken. Baseball Stars might have came out just before Bases Loaded. Bases Loaded was a good game.
I played it.
The biggest thing with Bases Loaded was you get into a fist fight. You know,
if
I would purposely beam the other player so that way they would charge the mound and you get into like a fist fight on the mound. But those were, I mean, I think those were probably my earliest. With Johnny, my cousin Johnny, we would play Zelda all the time. And I remember getting Final Fantasy, the first Final Fantasy on the NES, and Johnny and David got hooked on it as well. And I would take my cartridge down to Johnny, and Johnny loved it so much that he begged my aunt, my uncle to buy him a copy of it for Christmas. And then we would, all three of us were playing at the same time. We were constantly calling each other, like, with when we got stuck at points and stuff, like, how do we get past all this? And it was funny because all my cousins that played were always, they were all 2 years younger than me. Jamie,
but you're
was
lucky
two,
too. You had them all on the same street as
yeah,
you.
Yeah, we all lived on the same street. So, yeah. You know, we would. When I got my Super Nintendo, my brother had gone away with my uncle Evie, which was Jamie's dad, and Jamie, and then I think another uncle, and they went golfing or something in Myrtle Beach. And so my mom was like, well, you're home alone this weekend. Why don't you call Johnny up and see if he wants to spend the weekend with you and you guys could play your new Super Nintendo. And Johnny came over. We were playing, like, Super Mario World and to, like, man, forever. Like, it'd be, like, 1, 2 in the morning. My mom's like, are you guys going to go to bed? Because my mom's bedroom was, like, next door to ours.
She could hear it.
She could hear it through the wall. And we were, like, turning it way down, trying not to wake her up and stuff. And so that was always, like, good stuff back then.
That's fun that you had them all with you and you were able to do that.
Yeah, and it was constantly like that. Like, with David was always the one that was ahead of the times. Like, my Uncle Nelson always bought him the brand new stuff that came out. Like,
he's still like that.
Yeah,
your Uncle Nelson.
He tries to be. It's beyond his reach anymore. He can't keep up anymore. But when we were kids, we got Atari 2600s. Like, a month or two later, he's coming in with the 5200. And he's showing my dad and stuff. But my dad wasn't one of those keep up with the Joneses type of guys. Like, he was just like, whatever. These guys got a 70. They got a 2600. They're fine. They're good. They don't need nothing else. And then he got the ColecoVision. Then he got the NES. And I was constantly begging to get an NES, and they wouldn't get me one. And I was like, oh, this is killing me. So if you want to hear that full story, go listen to We the Gamer Cast.
I'm pretty sure I got mine before you got yours.
Yeah, way before me.
Spoils.
Yeah, exactly. But if you want to hear the full story about how I got my first NES, go listen to We the Gamercast. Look up the Geek Guru episode with Sean Capri and me, and I tell the whole story in a nutshell, and it's kind of funny how it all breaks down. All right, so the next topic I wanted to kind of get into real quick was, so Nintendo Switch is coming out less than a month, and they're flooding right now with commercials and everything. They're doing a Super Bowl commercial this weekend. How do you feel? Like, I'm a gamer. I'm a Nintendo fan, obviously. But you're not really up on everything as deep as I am. Like, mm-hmm. a lot of news, I'll tell you. Like, you don't really know what's going on. I'll have to tell you. And then you're like, oh, that's cool. Or, you know, like, whatever. What's your takeaway with, like, is it, like, are you seeing it? Are you not seeing it? Like, what's your takeaway with it all?
Like, am I seeing all the stuff that they're doing?
Yeah, like, are you taking notice of, like, Nintendo and the Switch and...
Even, like, on Facebook, on the little news feed, for maybe, like, 2 or 3 weeks now, it's been popping up.
Yeah.
Nintendo Switch on there, and, so, I mean, I see it on there. I've seen it on Twitter a couple times, too. I think that doing the commercial at the Super Bowl is a really smart idea.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to have people like me
mm-hmm.
who, you know, maybe aren't all up on it like you are and maybe know nothing about it right now, you know. And they're going to see that. I don't see how they could watch that commercial. That was a great commercial. And not want to get it. And plus kids, too. Kids watching.
Well,
I mean,
the thing, too, is like there's two commercials. So mm-hmm. one is like a minute and 30 seconds. That's not going to be in the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
It's a 30-second commercial. That 30-second commercial is really, in my opinion, geared towards millennials, towards mm-hmm. a young adult who has expendable income and is looking for a new gaming system. It's not, but if you watch the extended, you see the family, you see the older people. It's kind of more of like the Wii era, I feel.
In the 30-second version, because I don't know if we watched the 30-second version. I think I just saw the longer version.
Mm-hmm.
Do they have the part where you see people at a party playing once you switch?
No.
See, I think that would be good too, like for people like me. I'd be like, wow, you could play that, you know, with friends come over or whatever.
The 30-second version is the guy waking up in bed and he's playing the Switch and then he gets up
on the bus
and he goes out and he's making breakfast as he's playing and then he goes off, does something, and he comes home and then he plugs it into the base and then boom, it goes to the TV. Mm-hmm. Like, that's the thing with this is I feel like it's such a no-brainer when you see it. Like, I was telling people when they first announced the name Switch, when they did the first reveal, it was the NX at the time. Nobody knew what it was going to be. And I messaged you and I was like, oh my God, they announced the NX. They're calling it Switch. And I remember you were just like, that's a weird name.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, here. And I sent you the trailer. You watched the trailer. You're like, it makes sense.
Perfect name for it.
Yeah. And when you watch any trailer, anything, it's just like, boom, makes 110% sense. Like, you can't walk away and go, what is it? It's a no-brainer. It's, you know.
Make it look very easy. And I think it's good, too. I mean, we're, like, in the age where you just bring your electronics with you everywhere.
Yeah.
So that's, I mean, how much better can you get where you're playing at home and then it's like, oh, I gotta go somewhere. Let me just take it with you and just continue. Why wouldn't you want that?
And the thing with us is we're both huge Animal Crossing fans.
Yeah.
And we both love New Leaf. But the one thing that I always said to you was, man, I just wish I could play this on the TV, you know, mm-hmm. and when we were home. You know, as much as I loved playing all the time, I just loved the fact of, like, playing on the TV. Because I played the original, the GameCube version. That's what I introduced you to after we were dating for a little bit. And I was like, you need to try this game. I think you'll like it. And you got hooked on it. So then you didn't play Wild World. You didn't like Wild World.
No, I didn't like it.
I played Wild World a lot. And then City Folk got announced on the Wii. And we both. Actually, we
played that like crazy.
We actually went out and bought a second Wii so that way you could have a town and I could have a town, because we were sharing a town at first. And it was like, I would play for a couple hours, and then it was like taking turns. It would drive me crazy, because I'm like, I got to catch this fish, and you're playing right now, and I got to get on there. And so we got the second Wii and did that. I was upset that it never hit the Wii U. I really thought it was going to come to the Wii U, but it came to the 3DS. And that's actually why we bought 3DSs originally, because the promise of Animal Crossing. I remember the one E3, they did not talk about Animal Crossing at all. They announced it. Yeah, they announced it the year before. Then the next year, nothing. I remember tweeting Nintendo, like, what's wrong with you? How could you not talk about this? Did you cancel it? Is it there? Is it not? And then eventually it all came together. And
for Animal Crossing, I feel like that's the perfect best of both worlds. Like, we could play it on the TV, like, whenever it comes out. We could play it on the TV. And then, like, you know, I like to play things when we're in bed. Yeah. I can bring the thing to bed, play it there, because I log in a lot of hours on Animal Crossing. So.
Yeah, I want to say you put close to 800 hours in on it,
yeah,
if I'm not mistaken. And so for me, it's like, yeah, you get the best of both worlds. Like, we took our 3DSs to Disney when Animal Crossing first came out, and we played it all the time, you know, in Disney. But I am excited for Zelda. I'm excited for the two. I'm excited for Mario Kart. I'm excited for Splatoon. Like, I'm really excited overall for the whole thing, obviously. But
I'm excited over Splatoon, and I'm excited about Mario Kart, but I'm also excited about the Mario game, because I really want to play that too.
Yeah, yeah. Because you didn't play Galaxy 1
or
2.
No, I haven't played a Mario game since the 64.
Yeah. Yeah, Mario 64. Yeah. But I look at what they're doing with the marketing, and I like what they're doing. I like where they're targeting. I feel like, so obviously Switch is sold out. Nobody's going to get one day one. I mean, there might be a very few amount of people that get them day one, and that's because maybe Nintendo will do some restocks. Maybe the stores held back a little bit for in-store purchases. And then maybe some people just cancel their pre-orders, because I'm going to have, I'm doing If We Ran Nintendo tomorrow night with Chris White from Life of Gaming Podcast. He actually pre-ordered 5. Wow. But he's only keeping 3.
Yeah.
And Miguel, he bought
3. I was going to say Miguel did that.
Miguel bought 3. He's only keeping 2. There's a lot of people I know that did that. So when they cancel their pre-orders, there's going to be some that are going to be available, but not a lot.
Did they do that just in case there's a problem with
so
one of the
Miguel
stores?
Did it. So the reason why Miguel did it was because he wanted to, A, buy it for the best possible price, B, in case his brother wasn't able to get it, you know, or whatever, in case people he thought that he was friends with that wanted one that couldn't get it, that's why he got it. Chris had said that the reason why he got it was he got 5 was because he was worried about cancellations. So this way, if one pre-order, because that was a big thing with Amiibo, was you would pre-order, and then they would cancel them, and they would go, oh, it just didn't count. So he wanted to make sure that, like, he had them in place, so that way if something canceled, he was covered, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. So so when I look at that, I go, so here's Nintendo going to do this during the Super Bowl. Toby threw a figure at me yesterday, and he said that he heard that Nintendo spent, like, $5.5 million to run this ad. That tells me it's going to be multiple times. Because if I'm not mistaken, it's probably, now this is going back a few years, it used to be like $1 million for a 30-second ad. It might be $1.5 million now, so you might get 2 or 3 commercials out of it. But that is just an insane amount of money to think that's what they're going to spend for a 30-second spot. If they spent $5.5 million on one spot, that's just nuts. So I'm assuming it's going to be a few times.
Hopefully around the halftime, because I think that's, like, the best
time
to do it. Because a lot of people don't watch the game, and they just come in, like, for the halftime, too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I'm excited that this is the first time Nintendo's actually doing a commercial. It just seems to me that with the marketing, other than the announcement that happened 3 weeks ago or whatever, it just feels like they haven't stumbled this whole time. Like, their marketing is right on point. Like, they're getting people excited when they're watching these commercials. just because they're speaking to the gamer and they're just saying like, this, we know this is what you want and here it is and go get it. And so I'm excited for it ultimately.
Yeah.
I'm excited for the marketing because I'm happy to see them turning that corner, and especially with the Super Bowl commercial. I think that's going to be really,
that's a good idea. It's very smart.
Is there, so, okay. Cause I feel like you play games, but I don't feel like you're hardcore in your games. Like,
no.
You don't play consistent. Like, you'll play very sporadic. What games are you interested in right now for the Switch?
Definitely Splatoon. Totally Splatoon. And it's like, when I played the other Splatoon, you know, I really didn't do a lot of the other things, like the single player and things like that. And I really kind of want to get into that. Like, I want to do a little more with the games. so that Mario Kart, obviously, because I like to smack talk everybody on Mario Kart. And
to yourself, basically.
Yeah, basically. I yell at myself. But like I said, I'm looking forward to the Mario because it's been a long time since I played a Mario game. Mm-hmm. And that one just looked really cool to me and looked like something I wanted to try out. I like the stages that they showed. I really like the stage. I know Toby disagrees, but I like the stage with the real people. And I just think that's really cool. It's different.
Yeah.
You know, I might have a little trouble because I don't really know all like the new moves and things.
Yeah,
so.
It's not that, it's a Mario.
Yeah.
It's not that hard to pick up.
But I was so into Mario games. Yeah. So I would really, I'm excited about that game.
So, okay, let's just run through the list a little bit here. 1-2 Switch. Are you interested in that at all?
Not really, no.
Okay.
It didn't really, like, it was, I mean, it was cool. Mm-hmm. I would play it, but I'm not, like, dying to play it.
We're not buying it, so don't worry about it. ARMS? Did ARMS interest you at all?
That did. I thought that was pretty cool.
Okay.
And
what about ARMS did you like or not like? Like, what caught your eye with that game?
Honestly, it just looked like a fun game, but then when I read about, and you told me too, about like how you can actually feel the things that your arms are made out of going, you know, twisting out and stuff, I was like, wow, that's kind of cool. I want to kind of experience that. I want to check it out. Plus, it looks like a good workout.
Possibly. You can play it with a regular controller, too. You don't have to use the Joy-Con.
Yeah, but that's cool. I like that.
Zelda, are you interested in Zelda at all?
No.
No. That's fine. I'm just curious.
I've never really been into Zelda, even the first one. And I don't know why. It's a beautiful game.
Yeah, it looks gorgeous.
I don't know.
So you didn't play Hyrule Warriors, but you know what I'm talking about when I say Hyrule Warriors,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So the Fire Emblem Warriors, you don't have any interest in that then?
No.
And then I wouldn't think you have any interest in like 2K basketball or FIFA or anything
like
that. No. But the Mario game you're interested in. The Fire Emblem game. Yeah, I wouldn't think you'd be interested. I was going to say Skyrim, but I don't think you'd be interested in Skyrim. Skyrim is basically from the people that made Fallout, but it's like a medieval times type game, per se.
Actually, that sounds like it would be kind of cool.
I would
like to broaden my gaming horizons, though. So.
Well, playing Fallout is already a big leap, I feel. I feel like Fallout is, if you're going to, that's a huge, huge leap. So the one thing that I've been hearing a lot lately with this is the online system. So they're going to charge money for it, whatever, kind of like PlayStation does and Xbox does. The price is coming in probably $20 to $30 a year, which isn't bad at all.
No, that's pretty cheap, I think.
But the one thing that's kind of interesting, and now that I'm hearing more people get to talk about it, I'm really interested. So basically, like, and you don't know this because you don't really mess with PlayStation that much, but like with PlayStation Plus, what happens is like every month you'll get two games for free that you can download. So Nintendo's giving two games, or giving a game, they're saying, for free, but you only get it for the month. And then I don't know whether you can purchase it or not, or whatever it may be. But the idea is they're going to give you a Nintendo or a Super Nintendo game, and they're going to make them where they're online multiplayer as well. So, you know, you get a game like, you know, Super Mario Kart, the original on the Super Nintendo. You can actually play multiplayer on that. You know, a game like Contra, you could play two players together at the same time. Like, I could play with Sean or whatever. But hearing all that stuff, I'm like, this is kind of cool to some aspect. Like, when I think back of, like, some of the great multiplayer games growing up, like, that just seems kind of neat. Like, people have been really talking about this one game, Ice Hockey. And I don't know if you ever played Ice Hockey, but there's a fat guy, a skinny guy, and a medium guy. And you pick, you have four players that you pick from, and you have the goalie. That game was so much fun as a kid, like playing ice hockey as a kid. I would love to see that game just really get a multiplayer touch to it. But I think that's kind of neat that they're doing that, that they're going to go back and do that to the games and then bring them out and see what happens.
Yeah, I think so.
The I'm not sure how the losing the game at the end of the month works. I just don't know if it's like a special thing you get for the month. It's like something different they're doing, but we'll see how that all
works. You mean they can take it away?
Yeah, they're going to kind of... I don't know whether they're going to take the game away all completely, or they're going to say, like, okay, you don't get it for free anymore. You got to go buy it for a couple bucks or whatever. Which kind of stinks, honestly. Because I just think, like, just give it to the people. Stop. Stop charging people a million times for a game.
Yeah, because ultimately it's all about the money, man.
I know, man. But I'm tired of buying these games. Like, I bought Mario a million times. I bought Super Mario Bros. 2, like, I probably paid like $300 for this game. But
well, see, that's your problem right there. You shouldn't get Super Mario 2 because it's a bad game.
No, Super Mario Bros. 2 is the best.
No, it's not.
Best Mario Bros. It's better than Super Mario Bros. 3.
Super Mario Bros. 3 is the best one.
That's garbage.
Best one.
Sonic the Hedgehog is better than Super Mario Bros. 3.
No, it isn't. Super Mario Bros. 3 is the best.
Toby just got excited and got mad at me at the same breath. So, all right, so let's wrap this up with our final topic. Because I kind of thought today, I was like, you know what? I could probably bring this back to some geeky stuff because Toby won't ever talk to me about this stuff. He gets so mad when I want to talk about this stuff. And I kind of, we're not going to go spoilerish, but I do want to go geeky a little bit and earn some of my geek cred back because I feel like... Doing this show, I've lost a lot because Toby.
Trust me, you're pretty geeky.
Toby took me right off the rails. All he was talking video games all the time, and but The Walking Dead. Walking Dead comes back next week.
Yes, yes.
What are your hopes?
I should have geeked out about that.
What are your hopes with it returning next week? Like, what's something you hope, or what are you hoping to see happen out of all this?
I kind of already know
it. That's why I'm saying no spoilers, because I don't want to know.
But no, I didn't watch TV show spoilers. I'm just going based off the comic books. But
yeah, but they should.
They never stick to the comic. But not only very that, closely.
Not only that, they're to the point where they're passing the comics.
They're passing, but they're still in the comics.
Not much.
They're getting past that, though.
Yeah, they're not much into the comics. Because you don't know, because they've been changing stuff all, like...
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Robert Kirkman has been changing things all along, because he doesn't like how certain things played out in the comic, so he changes them for the TV show and stuff, so... and that's happened this past half, I don't want to... Or end of last season, it happened.
Yeah.
And, but, go ahead, what are you hoping to see take place in all this?
You know, I would say that I hope that it gets better because the first half was a little slow.
Yeah, very
but
slow.
I just feel like with The Walking Dead, they have to have that slow set of episodes to tell the story. Like, I know you don't like the episode with Tara, with those people from the ocean community.
I didn't mind it, but it was just... But at that point, my problem was by the time that hit, I was just like, come on.
Yeah.
Enough. I don't care.
They're skipping around.
Yeah, it was just because all this stuff hit. All this heavy stuff just hit. Get back to that. I want to know what happens. I'm to the point now where, like, they're making me really hate Negan. I think he's cool.
I love him.
I think he's cool, but I hate him. Because me personally, I love Rick. I just love Rick. And I feel like this whole time I've watched Rick just turn into this animal. Like, he's turned into Shane. Probably going a little bit beyond Shane at that point.
Oh, yeah.
But, I mean, if Shane was still around, Shane would be like Negan, honestly. That's the level I think Shane would have gotten.
Oh, yeah.
But
definitely.
I'm blown away that Rick is such a sissy
But you gotta, like, think about it. Like, he just saw two of his friends' heads get bashed in. And I just think that I think he's scared.
I don't think...
because he doesn't want other people to die.
But
like,
here's the thing.
He's scared, but I just think he's trying to save people.
So before they went to... where was the place they went to where they were cannibals?
Terminus?
Yes. Before they went to Terminus, those guys grabbed him and Carl and Michonne, and he bit the guy's throat out.
Yeah.
And then, like... they were outnumbered. I mean, it wasn't huge numbers like this, but, like, he just had no fear, and he, like, took people out, and it was like, they made him into a badass, and now it's just like, they're just kicking him down, and it's like, I think you could feel where, or at least you could start to see where he's, like, kind of biding time, but, like, the same thing, like, with the governor.
Mm-hmm.
They were outnumbered there.
Yeah.
The governor come rolling in with a tank. He didn't, like, bow down to him. Like, he fought back, and, like, that's the thing that drives me crazy, because I look at Negan and I go, okay, yeah, he's got a lot of numbers. Yes, he's crazy. Yes, he's a badass. But, like, you didn't know what was going up against the governor, and you totally fought back and you totally beat him. And this whole thing of, like, just laying down is driving me up the wall. And Carol, I want to choke her every time I see her.
Oh, she's getting on my nerves. She's getting on my nerves.
Like, just all of it. Like, just stop. They do this every... because this is the thing that drives me crazy. Is they do this thing where they're all together, and they're an unstoppable force. And they're just flowing together. Then all of a sudden, they all just start to go their own separate ways. And they get weak. And then all of a sudden, you're waiting for them to all come back together again. Because you know that together, you're not going to stop them. And it's just like...
yeah.
Enough.
Well, I think that's gonna happen. I'm hoping that happens.
That's what I'm hoping too. I'm hoping
they all, you know, figure out. Well, now they're all, not all of them, but a lot of them are together.
Yeah.
And I think the kingdom and I think that ocean group of women are gonna come together, and
I hope ultimately that's
will.
Ultimately, that's what I'm hoping happens. And I like Negan, but. And I think the reason why I don't like... at first I thought, like, okay, he's just trying to defend what's his. And I get why he's acting the way he is. Because, you know, Rick came in, he killed people and all this stuff. Like, okay, he's just defending his property. But then when you watch, like, when they took all the mattresses. And then they go down the street and the mattresses are burnt. And it's like, now you're taking it a step further. Because... now you're just messing with people.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, that to me is where I start to grow a disdain for him. Because to me, he's a bully. And like, the whole stuff with like, messing with Carl and all that stuff. It's like, I was waiting for Carl to blow his head off the whole time. I'm like, just do
it. He could. He was like right there.
Yeah, they both had.
He could have done it.
They both had opportunities. Carl and Rick both had opportunities. And that's the thing, like, when you look at it, it's like, come on, Rick. Like, you're not, they made him. That's where I lose interest, is when I feel like when they're making him to be something he's not.
Yeah.
Because he's not a weakling. He's not a sissy. And, like, he's been through a lot of stuff. And he knows how to fight, and he knows how to shoot, and he knows how to defend himself. And it's like, stop pulling back on him. Like, stop getting him up to a certain point and then pulling the reins back a little bit.
Yeah.
And the one thing that I regret all along, but I know that it happened in the comics and have it very own. But I so wish times that Shane was still around.
I do too.
Because this
they could have kept them. I mean, they kept them a lot longer than the comics.
Yeah, yeah. They built everything up.
I think though that he had to die to do exactly what you said, where Rick turns into him, basically.
Yes.
So, I mean, but I do miss Shane because I think Shane, this stuff wouldn't be happening if Shane's there.
No way. If Shane was there, man, forget about it. Like, it's a whole new ball game. Like, if Shane was still alive, that would be...
I think Tori would still be alive.
Well, I don't know about that, because she died from the pregnancy.
She's during childbirth, but yeah. I mean, I don't want her on the show.
Which technically, and I can't remember the comic, but she don't die that way in the comic book, right?
No, she dies during when the governor comes. Yeah, I think she gets shot, and then she's carrying Judith, and then she crushes Judith, and Judith is supposed to be dead by now.
Yeah, so that's where when you... Maybe they just didn't want to show that because they thought that might have been too
I don't think they want to kill off a baby on TV.
Yeah, it might be a bit much. Which I would have dropped that kid already by now.
She's Walker future to me.
Dude, that's what I'm looking at it as. If I'm getting, if there's a herd coming, I'm throwing that kid one way and I'm running the other, man. Sorry. People are gonna get mad at people. I'm just telling you.
Baby anyway, he knew it.
Yeah. It's not his kid. Stuff. Yeah. It's not my kid. I'm gonna die or this kidnap. Sorry, and people be mad, but that's just how it is. So basically, what I'm saying is, Sean.
Did you hear where they're gonna? I think this is a rumor where they said that because so many people complained about.
Don't get into spoiler stuff.
No, it's not really a spoiler though.
No, don't. If it's anything that's not, no rumors, no rumors. We're not doing that. We're not playing that game.
About what happens?
No. No, we're not doing it.
See, I can deal with spoilers. My answer, I've got spoilers, but he can't deal with it.
No, it has nothing to do with it. There's a lot of people that are listening, and they don't want to hear spoilers.
I'm not spoiling anything.
Whatever, shut up. Anyway, so my thing is Sean and Chelsea, if we ever come to an apocalypse, a zombie apocalypse, you guys just want to stay away from me. You have a newborn baby and all, and I might... toss the kid to save all of her. I would never do that.
What about
I'm just
this
kidding.
Guy? Here, what would
he'd
you
be
do?
Gone. The dog would be gone.
Oh, I'd save him over
nope.
you.
That's fine. You and the dog are dying because I'm just going to take off. Whatever. Freedom, baby. It's gone.
Now I know what to do with you.
If you're smart, you just shoot me in the kneecap and run. Just like Sean did, or Shane did to Otis.
I was going to say, you're going to be like Otis. I'm going to leave you with Otis to get eaten up.
That's what you do, man. You take him out. That's the best thing that ever happened in that show. So that is all. A little bit of a quicker episode. It's a little shorter than typical. 13 minutes left, but whatever. That is all. Thank you guys for listening to us. iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, all that good stuff. Toni... thank you for coming on. I appreciate it.
No problem.
I needed the help.
I could be your last resort.
Please, come on. You're better looking than any of the resorts I had, so that's a good thing. See that? See how I bring it back home, people?
Nice. I'll try to do it.
Guys, take note. So, let everybody know, how can they follow you, find you, all that good stuff?
Well, I'm on YouTube. My channel is The Working Housewife. I'm sure all of your viewers are interested in home decorating, and
I'm sure some of the ladies are that listen.
Yeah, you know, and planners. Well, I don't really do planners as much, but so I'm there, and then I am on Instagram and Twitter at TWHToni, and then I have a Facebook page that is facebook.com/TWHToni. So basically, TWHToni everywhere. Yeah,
that's way to find her. but you know what? Before we wrap, I'll get into this. So when I first started doing this, I was doing the Geekcast. Or I was doing the... I'm sorry. Let me back it up. When I first started doing this, I was the Geek Guru. And I was doing YouTube videos as the Geek Guru. And you were the one that pushed me to do YouTube videos and all that. Because I didn't want anything to do with it. I always kind of wanted to do a podcast. And that's where I felt like... because I feel like I have a face for podcasting, not for video. I don't feel like I'm good looking enough for video. But whatever. I think you have a poor taste. Poor tasting man. So I started as a Geek Guru, and I wanted to kind of ask you this because I don't think we've ever talked about this before. But I was doing the Geek Guru stuff. I was doing a lot of Batman stuff. I was doing a lot of different related things in my videos. Then I come down. I do a podcast with Justin Masson, I did this podcast with Justin Mass, and then I come down to you and I'm like, I'm going to rebrand. I'm going to start over from scratch. After doing it for a year, up to like almost a little over 900 subscribers on the channel, I just quit the channel. What was your mindset when I said that to you? Like, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to just rebrand as a Nintendo guru. Like, what did you think?
I thought it was a good idea because, you know, when you do a YouTube channel, and I mean, I know you do the podcast on there, but you do videos too. Mm-hmm. I think that when you do a YouTube channel, it has to be something that you're interested in. Like, you can't just do stuff that, you know, is the cool thing to do right now. Yeah. Because it's going to be reflected in your videos. So I think that for you, Nintendo has always been a part of you and you're really into that. And I think that branding yourself as a Nintendo guru is a smart thing to do because you could tell, like, I mean, you know what you're talking about, you know, and I knew you would gain subscribers back again.
Yeah.
Cause you do put out very good videos, you know, actually you taught me a lot of stuff about videos too. I think it was a good move for you, and I think you're seeing it now.
Yeah, I think a year. It's a little over a year now. I'm not at the subscriber base I was, but to be fair,
your views are good though.
My views are very good, but yeah. To be fair, a year ago or a year and a half ago, whatever, when I was doing a Geek Guru channel, I feel like those numbers were fluffed because I did a lot of giveaways.
And I
feel like I gained a lot of subscribers off those giveaways, and I've done giveaways, but I do them through Twitter now, not because that was the other part of the rebranding. Because I was like,
I wanted to really work up your Twitter
more. I wanted true numbers. I wanted true numbers because I had 900 subscribers and I was getting like 20, 30 views, and it was like so frustrating because I couldn't figure and the people weren't there for me. They were there for the giveaways that I was doing.
Yeah.
And that became very apparent to me. Where now, the subscribers that are there, they're there for the videos, for the most part. And that's what I picked up on in all of this. So that's where I'm excited. That's where I'm happy where it goes. And because not that... So look, I'm never expecting to be a PewDiePie. I'm never expecting to be, you know, any of these guys that are making money off of this. Like, that's not my goal in all this. My goal is just to have a good time and have fun with it, and that's why I do it. If that happens one day, then thank you. I'm appreciative of that. But that's not my goal. That's not my end game with all this. Like,
it's all just having fun.
Yeah. So, like, but my thing is like, when you have 900 subscribers and you're barely pulling 20 views, it's almost like you sit there and you start to look at yourself like, why am I doing this?
Oh, yeah.
Because the time it takes to produce the video and do all this stuff, it's frustrating. So when I rebranded as a Nintendo guru and I started going with it, like, I left all that behind. I left the Geek Guru stuff behind and I went this way. But it felt good because now that, like, you get people watching and people tweeting all the time. Like, I'll show you tweets sometimes where people are like, oh my God, the Geek Guru, oh my God, the Nintendo Guru just liked one of my tweets. And I'm like, what? Like, who gets like, I'm nobody, man. Like, why is somebody getting excited? You know, like I told you,
yeah, you're nobody. I don't understand that. I know what you mean. It's flattering. It's very flattering.
Yeah, like it's kind
of because you know people are watching you and they're enjoying what they're watching, and that's a nice thing.
Like the day that I we have these convenience stores here in New Jersey called Wawa, and it's like a 7-Eleven or something like that. It's just a convenience store. It's a little deli, and I go there every morning to get coffee. And I went there one day. And I had been talking to this guy for a long time through Twitter and all that stuff. And I helped him get some Amiibo and I mailed him Amiibo and all that stuff. And he lives in New Jersey. And one day I'm sitting there at Wawa and he comes up, knocks on my window. He's like, are you Bobby the Nintendo Guru? And I'm like, yeah. And we're sitting there and we're talking for a little bit. And then like 5 minutes later, like 10 minutes later, he tweets and is like, I just met one of my favorite YouTubers, Nintendo. And I was like, wow. Like, this is just, you know what I mean? Like, that's crazy. Like, to me, that's what makes it all worthwhile. When people send a tweet to you, ask you a question, like Brendan Myers, you know what I mean? Like, I sent the tweet out today and I was like, hey, if you guys have any questions, send them out. And then like Brendan Myers sends a tweet and he's like, you know, with a question. And then I think it was Amiibo Steel was like excited that you were going to be on and all that stuff. Like, when you get those tweets from people, it's just like, That's what makes it worthwhile to me. That's my payment for doing.
See, I don't get that. I don't get anything like that. Yeah. But I, you know, my Twitter isn't as active as yours. Mm-hmm. My Instagram is. I get a lot of nice comments on Instagram all the time. Yeah. But I don't get like people like, oh, I just, you know, this person, she just liked my tweet, and you know, I don't get that. And I have more subscribers than you.
I know. Listen. The people love me. I love the team.
I know. Well, that's, look, see, that just shows, like, I have, what do I have now? 4,300 subscribers. Uh-huh. And you have, whatever it is.
400.
But you're getting people interacting with you more, and I just think that that is more exciting than the views.
I feel like a lot of that is Sean. And what I mean by that is, when Sean and I started If We Ran Nintendo, we took on this mindset, like, we immediately started talking to the people that were listening, mm-hmm. and we immediately started acknowledging the people that were listening. And it kind of started this whole thing. Like, I feel like when Sean and I did that podcast, which is almost a year ago now, it started this train moving of, like, interaction with people. And, like, people will tweet us, and especially after last week when Sean yelled at me and got nasty with me.
Go, Sean!
So after that, like, you started to see, like, people we hadn't heard from before, like, coming out of the woodworks, like, saying something. It was like, wow, like, this is kind of powerful stuff. And, you know,
I feel, Sean, if I had to talk to you, like, you know, every weekend on a podcast, I'd get frustrated too.
Keep it up.
You're pretty frustrated. But I'm glad that you, you know, did the rebrand, mm-hmm. and it's working out, because I think that if you're going to do a YouTube channel, like, if you're thinking of starting out a YouTube channel, you just have to know that it takes a lot of time to start getting the views. You might start out with like 5 views on a video, you know, and no subscribers. I always said that I talk to the camera as if I have millions of subscribers. Yeah. And I think that's what you have to do.
And the one person that, and I'm not trying to call him out now,
Toby?
he frustrates me a little bit sometimes, because I feel like he doesn't, he sometimes he'll lack confidence in himself, and he thinks like, oh, nobody wants to watch me and all. And
I was enjoying his vlogs.
I loved his vlogs. Like, would you stop, man? And it just, and that's what I feel like, don't get, like, that's the thing. You're not, you gotta do it because you love it. Because mm-hmm. if you're doing it because you want to get famous or you want to get a lot of people watching, it's not going to work. You're going to get frustrated. But I feel like I wish Toby would go back and do the vlogging, because that was so much fun. Toby. Yeah, they were so much fun. And
I used to look forward to it. I'd see it in my subscriptions, and I'd be like, yes, the Toby vlog. And I would watch it right away.
Real quick, though, before we leave, before we shut down, which I said 13 minutes ago I was going to shut down, but whatever. So I wanted to, just because I have you on the show, I wanted to say something to Josh Stapleton, who tweeted you about Fixer Upper, and because he was like, he was like, don't tell the Nintendo Guru or something, because whatever he, you know, whatever he said or whatever. But I used to watch it a lot. I feel like that show is better for marathons for me than to watch, tune in every week for an hour or whatever. I do like the show. I think it's a good show. I love Chip. Chip is the man. Like. Great. That's the only reason I watch this show.
He loves the whole show. He really does.
Oh, yeah. He's so funny. Like, honestly, I could watch the first half of the show, and then when Joanna takes over, I could just shut it down and leave. Because I love Chip. Chip's a nut, and he makes me laugh. So, anyway, that is all. You can follow the podcast on Twitter at @the_geekcastpod. Follow me, Twitter, @NintendoGurus. Check out Toby, too. He's @Toby_take, even though he's not here right now. Peace out, Cub Scout. Say bye.
Bye.
It's like I'm dealing with Toby all the time.